So this is the Ideas Lab, and usually the best ideas come up when you think outside the box. And this is especially true for some old topics, when people always think in a certain way. They don't question anymore the theories or the practices or what they are doing. My example is related to solar cells. And of course, this is the goal that we all want to have, the green Earth. In order to reach this, we just have to make the solar panels more affordable. The good news is that the industry already knows how to make good and rather cost-effective panels. People are actually quite happy when they measure, measure the power output of their brand new solar cells coming right after their manufacturing lines. The problems appear when they put these solar panels outside. They are, after all, solar cells. They must be put outside. The sunlight is harmful for them. Basically what happens, the power output starts to gradually degrade from the initial value. And this degradation can be actually as high as -30% from the initial value. And this is actually a big loss. And this will also have a huge impact on the cost of the solar panels. If you think about a standard size of the photovoltaic company today who produces about 1 gigawatt solar panels per year, for them it means millions of euros of losses each year. And now if we think globally, how many companies we already have and how much production we already have, the numbers get much bigger. The problem is not a new one. It's been there for a long time, basically from the beginning. But the impact has become bigger and bigger each year because the technology advances and the solar cell efficiencies become initially higher and we get much bigger outputs initially. But what's causing all this trouble then? Well, you can call it a mystery, but there is one old theory which most people believe in, and that's related to oxygen and a reaction of oxygen with light. However, if you believe in this theory, basically you have to make some trade-offs. You have to use material that is free of oxygen. And this kind of silicon which doesn't contain oxygen is very expensive. So I wouldn't call it as a solution. Therefore, it's a good time to think outside the box. I have background in microelectronics. And previously, I have noticed that in these microelectronic devices, different light sources have caused some troubles for the device operation. And in most cases, the root cause for this failure was found to be ionized copper. Now, having this in mind, I raised the question, if the solar degradation that we observe in the panels today is due to the ionized copper, what is even more important and what I'm excited about is the solution that I'm proposing, how we could get rid of this problem. Well, we know that copper is positively charged and it moves very easily in silicon, even at room temperature. And then positive and negative charge attract each other. So what if we put some negative charge on the solar cell surfaces? What happens is what you see in the picture. So we can kind of get rid of this harmful copper. And actually, our preliminary results are quite promising. So the next question will be, of course, when do we see this idea in production? What is the time scale? Well, the idea that I just presented to you is very fresh. And I have just received ERC grant to do studies on this topic. So we, of course, have to do more testing on this, but I hope it will happen soon. And then my final slide is about the importance of collaboration between industry and academia, even though we are doing fundamental research. And my question to you is, how can we encourage the solar cell industry to implement these novel technologies into their production? Thank you.